Peggy 18.
No, you can't get there first. They have to eat. Yes, I know. No, you can't go first either. That's not happening. No, I'm gonna talk about that first. No, definitely. Anyways, no, not happening. Okay? Hi everybody, and welcome to this latest Kickstarter update for Divinity Original Sin 2. We have lots to talk about today, because we are going to be talking about what exactly is Divinity Original Sin 2, the definitive edition. We'll talk about the details of that. We will talk about the grandest job opportunity of a lifetime, so be sure to check that out. And we're going to look at because I've got some awesome thing to show to you. Yes, we'll talk about you, but you have to wait. Okay, so without any further ado, let's start flashing around the office because there's really a lot of content to cover. Let's go! All right, so I'm here with Nick, who is our systems designer. And Nick, you've been looking at the analytics that we've been getting from players who've been playing the game for some time now. And you saw certain problems and things that we needed to fix. And so you spent quite a lot of effort in addressing those. So what exactly is it that you've been doing?
Right, so we were collecting a lot of data and we were reading a lot of forum posts from our players. And we found some legitimate problems, especially in the late game, where the pacing got a bit stale. So we revamped the gold curve and XP curve from a second act onwards.
Yeah.
And we also rebalanced armor in all the fights.
So we also introduced a story mode. And how exactly does that work, actually?
So story mode is for players who want to focus on the dialogue and the atmosphere and spend a little bit less time in combat. So it's a more casual difficulty mode below Explorer.
And you can change whenever you want.
Yes, at any time you can switch between Story, Explorer and Classic mode.
Okay, and that's typically the thing you would do if a combat is too hard or you didn't manage to your
party. Or if it's too easy for you, if you feel like you've mastered
the game,
you can bump it up a bit and see how it goes.
Okay, thank you. Well, speaking of combat, we've also had a look at several combats in the game, and Edouard, who is our combat designer, had a say in that, and let's have a talk with him and see what kind of things he's been doing. So, Edouard, what have you been doing for Definitive Edition?
I worked on the number of fights, like about 8 or 10, and I remade them completely, so they're better. And also, I added new fights. For instance, in Kemp's Garden.
Yeah.
Now you're gonna have a surprise if you go there. Okay. So I reworked the Kraken in the harbor scene completely, because I found it. I always thought it was a bit underwhelming that you see the Kraken like really emerge from the sea like this, and then just go back into the
water. Yeah, and you couldn't fight the Kraken.
You could
right?
not fight it.
And now you can.
Exactly. Now you can.
Which is really cool.
So we made an entire new
kick that Kraken's ass and make him go away. The Kraken is a fight that you're gonna find when you hit Act 3, when you hit the City of Arcs. And there's been quite a lot of changes in Act 3 also at the story front. And to talk about those, we're gonna pass by Farang and Kevin. So let's go and have a look at what they have to say. Give me a second. So, Farang, you've been working on some of the level design changes that we've done for Definitive Edition, but you've also been handling the new tutorial. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's true. So basically, we noticed from PAX and all the events that we did that people were actually, you know, there was a lot of information and game mechanics coming at them at the same time. So we decided to add an extra deck with some rooms that have some gameplay in there that gradually introduce the mechanics of the game so that you're not really overwhelmed as a player.
Yeah, and we also linked that to the story.
That's absolutely true. Yeah, new characters in there.
Yeah. So that meant obviously that we, since we voice recorded everything, that we had to do new voice recordings. But that's not the only thing we voice recorded, because we did, like, if I'm not mistaken, there was over 100k words of changes and text.
Yeah, we had to re-record a lot of stuff, and we also adjusted stuff and we put the tutorial things in there.
Set me free, and I'll set you free.
We do it through this. This is our voice recording tool. We call it VRM for short. We're still recording, we're doing pickups, and this accurately shows the percentage of lines we still have left, and it gets updated daily by the recording studio. So this is
so they're seeing the same view over
exactly. There. This is literally what they're seeing in the studio, and we can just work around with this. Really handy to get stuff going.
Okay, cool, thank you. Well, let's go to Kevin and actually talk a little bit about what's in those lines that are being re-recorded. Thank you, Farah. So, Kevin.
Hello.
Hi. We're talking about the changes that we're making to the Definitive Edition versus the original version of Original Sin 2. And I've been talking up the amount of changes that we've been doing, that we're doing to Arcs, which is the last part of the game. And you've been working heavily together with the scripters
on changing the lines.
Yes.
That were there.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about the changes you guys did.
So a lot of it has to do with character motivation. Who is the bad guy? Who is it exactly that you're chasing after? Trying to do this without spoiling anything, which is a little harder than I expected. So that was a big part of it. Just making sure that people understood exactly what they were up to. Exactly what everybody's motivations were, whether it was your character's motivation or whether it was just the motivations of the people around you. Some of that also involved Beast's story. In Act 3, his story wasn't really coming together as well as we thought it should, so we took the opportunity to sort of revamp Beast, get more moments in there, in arcs that he could participate in.
Is she inside then?
I'm told Justinia came to express her best wishes for the bride and her father.
And you also did work on the end game?
Yeah, the end game. I can't say it's been fully rewritten, but it's been largely rewritten. It's a lot more reactive to the decisions that you made before that, and that includes the epilogue, you know, the things that when the game's winding down, you still get a chance to sort of tie up some loose ends, and I think we made those loose ends a lot tighter.
All right, cool. Well, thanks for that. We won't spend too much time talking about it because we have spoiler alert things coming up. And I need to go talk to the programmers because they too have been working very hard on the Definitive Edition, and the modifications that they've been making will have a big impact also on the PC version. So let's go and chat with them. Hi, Bert. Bert is our technical director. And tell me what you're doing.
I'm having a look at the current state of our performance on one of the consoles.
Okay, what are the bars?
The bars tell me how much time is spent on certain pieces of the code. So, for example, I see a part which is physics here, like plot simulation. I can see how much time it takes, on which cores it's running, and how
so these are different cores?
These are different threads running on the cores on the console. So then I can see which parts of the code are being waiting on something else or what is not that efficient yet.
So one of the things that I like about what you guys are doing is the little tools that you build to make your jobs easier. Actually this thing here, which Buzz is doing, he's just fast playing the game, I guess.
Yes, he's testing the streaming actually. So he's verifying if the streaming is fast enough, if he can keep the bandwidth low enough to make sure that everything gets streamed in on time.
And you also made a really cool tool to check the memory in the game and the frame rate actually.
Yeah. So we have an internal tool here that we're using a lot.
Yeah.
So this means that we start every night.
Hi, Yoko, by the way.
Hi.
Every night the consoles take the latest version that was built from the build server. Mm-hmm. It goes through a test suite, going over the levels in a systemic way.
So that's Fane floating over the world?
Yeah, it just goes over the world line by line. So we can also see over in 2D on top of the world.
Mm-hmm.
So there you can see we have like our range is now around 30 FPS, so everything is green. So we hit our 30 FPS targets everywhere.
Which is really good.
Which is good,
yeah. Okay. Cool. All right, thank you. We haven't finished yet because we still have a bunch of changes that we've been doing. And that is, we have Bobby!
I know.
Getting high on your own supply.
Okay,
I'm gonna do it. So, this is Bobby's vinyl record that was made with the Music of Divinity Originals in 2. It's an awesome edition. And you get this really...
Oh.
This is the gold edition.
This is the gold one.
It's pretty cool. It's got B from Bobby. anyway, we're here to talk about the Definitive Edition and the changes that have been done.
Absolutely. As a matter of fact, we just finished a really exciting improvement in the music. I believe you remember the moment when we were discussing where would be the best place to play your Origin theme music.
Yeah.
And I completely forgot that the best place actually was Lady Vengeance itself.
Does that mean that if I'm Red Prince and I go to the Lady Vengeance, I will hear Red Prince's theme?
Exactly.
And very cool. So that's going to be in Definitive Edition.
It's going to be in the Definitive Edition.
Okay. Thank you very much, Bobby.
You're welcome.
All right. So don't forget, guys, Bobby's awesome vinyl edition. Yeah, available now. You can go and get it. Well, it's very limited. I think there's not that many left. Yeah. So, and it also contains that's the main theme, right? So these...
I believe it is.
All right. So, that should give you a overview of the things that are coming to Definitive Edition. There's thousands of changes that we've been doing. We already talked in the previous update about UI changes that have been coming. So, and also everything related to the journal, which is a massive update for us because we spent a lot of work on that. So all in all, when you are going to get this version in your hand, you will hopefully think, yes, this is the Definitive Edition.
So, I have more.
No, not you, Laura. Not yet, okay? Your time is coming. We are expanding. As you may know, Larian Studios consists of four studios. We have one in Ghent, Belgium. We have one in Dublin, Ireland. One in St. Petersburg, Russia. And one in Quebec City, Canada. And all four of these teams are currently hiring because we are working on some very cool new games that we haven't announced yet. And if you are interested in working at Larian Studios, you should definitely check out larian.com/jobs because there may be something there for you. And maybe not for you, but for a friend who works in the games industry or for somebody who wants to be in the games industry. So be sure to go and check that out. That said, what else do I have? Oh yes, there's two things that I want to show you. So we're gonna have to move up, Declan, so that's fine. We'll follow. All right. Okay, let's go. It's the fantastic Sir Laura and his incredible steeds. So, why have I been walking around the entire day with a squirrel following me? Well, Sir Laura and his fantastic steed is the mini companion that we're offering as a free DLC for people who buy the definitive edition before it actually releases. And obviously that includes all of you, so you're gonna get it also. So to talk about Sir Laura, I have here Zoe who animated Sir Laura, and I have Gigi who wrote the first dialogue of Sir Laura, and Stephen who is not here, but who wrote the rest of the dialogue. So we think about you, Stephen, when we're talking about Sir Laura. Okay guys, so just explain, who is Sir Laura?
So Sir Laura is a squirrel knight, yep. And he, together with his trusted steed Quercus, is on a quest to stop the coming of the great acorn, because if the great acorn comes, he will ravage the world.
So you animated him? What was the coolest animation you did for him?
The coolest was probably the idol that I made.
Okay, and what does that do?
He basically just slides down his back and does a spin.
So, do I need to have pet pal to talk to him?
You do.
Oh man, so that means if I don't have pet pal, I don't have...
No. Well, actually no, we took that into account, so just by communicating a lot of eeps and eeps. Actually, still follow you around if you like. Yeah. And if at any point in the game you decide to get pet pal, you can still start talking to him then, and he will still introduce himself.
You know full well who I am, you silly old cat, the great Sir Laura.
And so does that guy have like a story arc?
He does have a story arc, yes. Which I'm not going to spoil, but it is very much, I guess, the most impressive story arc ever given to a squirrel.
Well, I mean, people played the first Original Sin. I should remember that there was actually a story of a great acorn coming. Remember all those squirrels that you talked to if you had that pass? Anyway, so can we recruit him, Zoe?
Yes.
Yeah, there you go. So now he's following you. And what happens in combat, actually?
In combat, he does not participate. Basically, he kind of recruits us as his shield, is what he calls us. Mm-hmm. And so we keep him safe.
Oh, we have to keep him safe on top of that.
You would have me use this giant for a... shield.
All right, cool. Okay, great. Well, thank you guys. So that was it for today. We talked about the definitive edition, we talked about Sir Laura, we talked about the jobs at Larian, and I think that it's gonna be it for today. that is it, guys. Until next time, I guess very close to the launch of the Definitive Edition. And who knows, maybe at some point we will actually reveal to you what it is that we're working on right now with all of the team. Take care, guys. Bye bye!
Yeah, no, no, come on. Sharp shooting skills for me, and you don't want it. Come on, Laura. You can do it, Laura. You can do it.
You suck, Laura.
You're not very good at it. Oh, perfect. You got it?
Just let me know when.
No.
Oh, you have the squirrel. you want to see something cool? Completely natural.
So, I have more.
No.